Yuri Kasdorp from Oracle Red Bull Racing Esports, and today we're here with another track guide for Coach Dave Academy. This time we're on week 11 for IMSA in the Porsche GT3, and we are at Le Mans. It's going to be an interesting one. I predict a lot of people are going to be a bit of a different downforce levels, so the races should be very interesting to see what's going to be working the best throughout the race. And without further ado, let's get into it and see how this looks like. So we're here to start the lap. Try to get close to the off tracks here. Take quite a bit of curbs on both sides. Especially on the quali lap, we'll have to be careful because the tires will be quite cold. We don't get much of a run to warm up here because we start at the end of the lap. So first sector will be quite tricky. Want to keep the car to the inside here. And use all the way up to the gravel here. Try to set the car for a good exit. And we'll go over exactly where all the off tracks are later on in the detail. Try to keep the speed up on the inside curve here. Now we're coming up to Tetra Rouge. Very important corner because you set up all the run all the way down the back straight. And then on the straight, we want to look out. In the LMP cars, you want to drive on either side of the road. In the GT cars, you want to drive in the middle. That's to do with the camera in the car, and you get a bit more speed if you drive exactly in the middle, only in GT cars. Before the brake, you want to make sure to move over to the left. Focus on getting good access out of here. Again, very important to learn exactly where those slowdowns are. It's the name of the game around Le Mans iRacing. And we'll go over that in more detail in the analysis. Keep the car in the middle of the track. Till we get over to the braking, then we want to open up the next corner. As much as we can. We want to open up the next corner. Use the curbs. Then again, we can use a lot of that curb on the left as long as we know exactly where that slowdown is. And the slowdown there is not on the edge of the curb, it starts somewhere in the middle. That's why we can run very wide on the exit and use the track there. Coming up to Millsand Corner, again try to set up straight braking. Try to get a good exit out of here. Again, we'll look for the middle of the track. It's going to give you a bit of free time across the lap. It's going to maybe amount to a couple hundred, so maybe a whole tenth. Free time. Then we're going to be running up to Indianapolis, which will be quite tricky. The car will be quite overseer into here. Try open it up. Keep the car stable. The car to the right, to speed up. Arnage, the slowest corner of the track. And use the curb on the left there to open up the corner. It's a bit of a trade-off, the curb can upset the car, but you do get a better entry. So have an experiment there, what you like best there. Either running completely over the curb like I did, or not taking the curb at all. We're coming up to the high-speed section, the Porsche cars. The car is going to be very on edge because we've trimmed out all the downforce from the car as much as possible. Take a bit of the inside grass here. As I said, the car is very trimmed out on downforce. Keep the speed up. Then end the lap to forge the gains. Try to cut them as much as possible, as much as we're allowed to. Go over to the left. And there we have it, the lap of Le Mans. Now let's analyze the lap and get a bit deeper into it. Right, so here we are having a closer look at the lap around Le Mans. Starting the lap. We've got two choices here. In the quali lap, it might be good to run close to the wall, but then you need to have a bit of a sharper corner up until turn one. For the race, it could be easy to just track out wide to the left quite early. Again, to have a bit of a shallower angle into the corner here. You want to be using all of the track on the left here and slowly start bringing the car over to the right. And it's very important here to get the car lined up straight for your braking for the first chicane, the bottom chicane. It doesn't matter as much if you have to lift here a bit. As you can see, I went off the throttle a bit here. What matters the most is that you've got the car lined up in a straight line here, so you can easily brake for the Dunlop chicane. If your car tracks out to the middle of the track, you're going to struggle braking in a straight line and start missing the apex a lot more for turn two. So want to brake in a straight line. Again, if you look from the outside, we're allowed to use all of this track on the right side. There's only a slowdown if you use too much of it here in the apex. Afterwards, you can start to use all of it. Then we get to the apex of the first left-hander. And roughly where the slowdown here is if your left tires start touching the gravel. So you want to use all of this on the inside. We don't even need to look at the white line. We want to look at our left side tires getting close to the gravel, but not quite hitting that. That way we use all of the track that we're allowed to without getting that slowdown. And we got a similar thing here on the right, where you can use quite a bit on the right, but there's no real marker here like the gravel is on the first left-hander. So this takes a bit of experimenting. You can take quite a lot of the inside here, but again, try to experiment with it a bit. And this one is not as important on the apex as it is on the exit. On the exit here, if we look at this here, we got these two signs, the flappy things. And these two will be our reference to where we get the slowdown. And the middle of the car cannot exceed the left side here, like go left of these boards. So we come here and we try to have our car with the middle of the car to the right of these. And you see that the first one's not as far to the outside as the second one, meaning that after this first one, we can go a bit further outside and use as much runoff as we can. And for the corner here, again, we want to just line the car up in a straight line on the right so that when we're braking, we don't have to keep bringing the car to the right. Very important, just keep the car on the right so you can start braking, keep the speed up. Want to follow the curb on the inside here. And then if you've done this corner right, you should be able to take the next corner flat out quite easily in the GT3 car. Now we're coming up to Tetra Rouge. Tetra Rouge, again, very important to carry the speed out of this corner because the whole run from Tetra Rouge to the first chicane will be dependent on the exit you get here. So it's very important to open up the entry as much as you can, the left side tires as close to the gas as you dare. Try to brake and be on throttle around the apex at least. Again, you can use a bit of the curb on the inside here. A reference here is about the left side tires can touch the left side white line. You can't take as much as turn one on the off track here, but again, the apex is not as important as the exit here. The exit is much more important, and on the exit, you can use all of this, which might sound strange, but you can use all of this off track on the left side up until a point. And that point is where this curb ends. And where this curb ends, the middle of your car needs to be back into the track. I think it's back into the middle of this drainage pipe. So you can run all the way wide, you can run close to the gravel, but you'll have to turn too much at the end. So you still want to be running fairly close to this drainage pipe without going too far over it, otherwise you'll have to turn back to the track too much at the end. If you feel like you're going wide, keep in mind that you can use this outside, but you have to be back before where the curb ends. We got the straight. All we have to do in the straight is roughly take the apex, but also keep our car in the middle of the track. And that's because the track has a bit of camber to the left and right. And running the car in the middle of the track keeps the car a bit lower, I think. Regardless of what causes it, on the GT car, we don't bottom out, so we want to run with the middle of the car on the white line throughout the straight. Then we get to turn the first chicane. And again, we want to use all of this track on the left side. We want to stick to the middle as long as we can, and then start using the left side of the track and corner entry. So we want to build it over to the left. There's a couple bumps here, so experiment a bit how much of the bumps you can take Just try to keep the car as straight as possible. If you keep them as straight as possible, these bumps won't upset the car as much. And we try to aim with the left side of the car that we're turning in. And a good reference point is that you almost or just about hit this cone going into the corner. Then you know you've done a good job. So we almost want to hit the cone. The brake marker here will depend a bit on how much entry speed you can carry, if you've got slipstream or not on your fuel. It's somewhere where this barrier ends, as a reference, sometimes a bit before, sometimes a bit after. Then again, we have the chicanes here. The off-track in the chicanes is not the white line. It's the middle of the car being on this curb. So experiment a bit how much that looks like from the car. But the middle of the car needs to be on this curb. If it goes over this side, you're going to get a slowdown. And the same will happen in the middle here, where it's not this line, but the middle of the car can be on the curb, not over that. Then on exit is different. On exit, we are, again, just like Tête Rouge, allowed to use all of this up until a certain point. And there's no reference here for that at all that I know of. Somewhere in the middle here, there's a slowdown if you haven't brought the middle of the car back towards the curb yet. So what you can do, like I'm doing here, is run wide and then just run in a straight line over the curb, so that by the time you get around the middle of the curb here, the middle of your car is again back into the track. That way you can use a bit more on the exit without getting a slowdown. Get to long straight again. We want to use the middle of the car on the white line, same as before. And second chicane is a very similar story. We want to bring the car over. Want to start braking around the 100 sign this time. Want to use this cone as a reference of turning in. Most of the time you're going to hit this cone just a bit, unlike the first chicane where you tend to miss it. So we hit the chicane or the cone a bit. The left side, you'll see that this curb has a bit of an edge to it compared to the first chicane where there was no edge, where it was more flat. You can use this curb to kind of hook the tire behind and use it as a bit of turning. So you want to get the tires just about on this curb here, slow the car down, and again, most important thing on these chicanes is the exit, not your entry speed. So try to get a good run into the second corner. Again, middle of the car needs to be on the curb here, doesn't need to be the white line. And then on exit here, we have a reference, unlike the first chicane, we have a reference where you see this bit of curb coming up. And you want to be back into the track before this curb here. So what you normally do is look at this as a reference or this, and then get back to the track around this. What I personally use is that if you use this as a reference, so if you look from the car's perspective, you see this bit of the curb coming up a bit. I want to put my right side tires here, the left side tires here, getting back. That way you're over it and the car doesn't bounce on it. That way you just smoothly get off the curb. Then we'll get to Milsand corner. Again, we want to open the car up, the corner up, get the car to the left side, start turning in while we're on the throttle, and then try to brake as much in a straight line as we can. If you brake in a straight line, we've got more brake force and the tires can brake harder than if you need to turn while braking. Important here again, try to line the car up for a good exit. The inside will be middle of the car, again on the edge of the curb. You can almost hit these cones on the inside. But again, experiment how that looks like from your car, where you get the slowdown. The corner exit here, there's no slowdown. You can run all the way up to the gravel, that's fine. Again, the straight, same story as the back straight. We just want to use the middle of the car on the crown of the road. Then we get to a very tricky corner, Indianapolis, where we want to use the middle of the car. Needs to be on the edge of this green. If you go way over this, you're going to get an off-track, not a slowdown. You don't gain much time for it, so I wouldn't recommend getting the off-track, but it's not as scary as getting a slowdown, which will ruin your lap or your race completely. Make sure to stay on throttle a tiny bit here. It helps with the rear being stable if you struggle with that. If you start braking exactly under compression here, it's easy to lose the rear. So I lift a bit before the corner, then hold a bit of throttle through the apex here. Try to bring the car up to the right, and again, brake in a straight line as possible. Second gear. Corner exit here, you can run with your right side tires all the way into the gravel. If you run, again, middle of the car too wide to the right, you will get an off track here. Anash, the slowest guy on the track, where I talked about as well quickly in the hot lap, you have two options here. The first option is to keep the car stable and not use the curb at all. That way your left side tires will have to be on this darker line. And the car won't get upset into the corner, but you'll have a bit of a shallower line into the corner. The second option is lining your car up all the way on the left here. And then with your left side tires, you have to go over the curb. If you have a good line for this, the car won't get too upset. So we arrive here, slowly take our car over the curb without trying to get it too upset. We'll take a couple tries. In some cars, it's quite tricky. In the Porsche, I found it to be useful to take that extra meter on the corner entry without the car getting too upset. Here we're aiming with the left side tires to almost clip or just about clip the grass. Just avoid the wall, there's no off-track here. You could try to be on the middle of the track here again, but it's quite more meters that you have to run. So I'd normally choose to stick to the inside on this straight here. Let me get to the Porsche curves. Porsche curves will be very tricky, especially with the new aero model, because we try to trim as much downforce away from the rear as we can to again get more top speed on the straights. But it will be very tricky on the rear to keep it through the Porsche curves. Again, what helps here is trying to enter the corner a tiny bit slower and keep a bit of throttle on. That will make sure that you've got a bit more weight on that rear end than you normally would. Get to the inside here. Again, this is the same as Indianapolis. You want to have the middle of the car on the edge of the green here. So left side tires can be on the green, middle of the car on the edge of the green, and there will be an off-track, not a slowdown. Again, slowly into it and be on throttle quite early. We'll keep the rear stable. Then an interesting one here, if you struggle with understeer, you can use a lot of grass on the inside. There is no off track quite early, as long as you keep your right side tires on the curb here. I found that the off track's very far to the inside. And what that does is the grass on the inside has a bit more resistance than the tarmac on the right. So it slows the left side of the car down and it pulls you towards the apex. So if your car understeers here a bit, using a bit of grass on the inside can be very helpful. You can see here as well, when I use this bit of grass here on the inside, my car is quite on the edge. Coming off of it, it got a bit unstable. Need to figure out if it's worth it running your setup or not. If it's oversteery, I wouldn't recommend using the grass on the inside. And then we want to make sure to just use all of the entry on the next corner. This corner as well, you can use a bit of the grass to get the car rotated, but it's off track earlier than on the previous left-hander here, so you need to be a bit more careful. Right-hander into karting, we want to hug the white line on the inside all the way through. Again, have small inputs in the whole corner, and a bit of throttle will keep the rear settled better than if you brake quite deep into the corner. For karting here, try to get the car lined up as far to the right as possible, focus on a good exit. Get towards the inside where the curb starts. And then on the exit, it's a similar situation as Tetra Rouge, where you can use all of this as a racetrack. But the limit is at the end here, the middle of the car needs to be back onto the track. I was very close to the off track here. It's about where the middle of the car is with the curb. Another reference would be the left side tires on the white line here. So that's the reference I use. It's very, very close to the off track here. Then coming into the four chicanes. Interesting here is that you want to use a bit of the pit lane as a racetrack. And what that allows you to do is get a bit of a straighter run and up into the four chicanes. So once this pit lane opens up, you want to start using this. And before braking, you want to angle your car a bit towards the inside curb. That again allows you to brake a bit in a straighter line. Get a bit more speed into the corner. So we'll play that. The off track again here is where the middle of the car will be on the curb. Good reference as well is that your right side tires need to be on the edge of the curb. If they go over that, you're going to get the off track. Same here. Try to bring the car as far to the right as possible. For this one here, you want to jump over the left side curb. Again, middle of the car on the curb, right side tires on the edge of the curb. You can be a bit further to the left here as I was. the right side, you want to either avoid this or completely jump over it like I did here. The slowdown on the inside here is quite far. I don't know exactly how far, but whenever I feel like I'll get a slowdown and it's on the edge, then I don't get a slowdown. So the limit will be inside or middle of the corner. I think even around this red here, you can use a whole bunch of it. So try to experiment with that. But I was here, I was still quite far with the slowdown. And then the corner exit, you want to run all the way to the gravel. There's no slowdown on the exit. There's only an off track. There we have a lap of Le Mans. So in summary, a lot of the speed we get around Le Mans is knowing exactly where we can use the track to our advantage and where the slowdowns exactly are. And you can learn those. You can use the reference I used, but it will take a bit of practice and a bit of reference the way you're looking from the car, exactly where those slowdowns are. So I recommend just a bit of practice. Try to not get frustrated getting a slowdown. Try to learn where they are, and then in the race, try to have a bit of margin to them to avoid getting those in the race, because it can be very costly. So there we have it, another track guide for Coach Dave Academy, this time in the Porsche around Le Mans. Again, very tricky track, but I think it will be popular and it will pay off to learn where the objects are. And I wish everyone good luck. And for more track guides, make sure to subscribe to the channel.